Hello friends, welcome you all to Shakti's Knowledge Hub. How are you all? Myself, Shakti Suganya. In our today's video, we are going to continue chapter 1 of part 3, Management is an Art or Science or the Profession. Let's see it in detail. Still in the field of management, there is an argument and discussion going on whether we can tell management is an art or management is a science or management is coming under a profession. So under that, today we are going to see about management, whether it is an art. Let's see it. What is telling us art? Art refers to skillful and personal application of existing knowledge to achieve desired result. If you want to perform something, you should have some knowledge about that particular thing. It can be acquired through study, observation and experience. Take an example. If you want to dance, you need to observe it thoroughly. Like studying, and also you have to experience it. You have to practice again and again to perform that particular art. Likewise, we have so many other examples to tell a term called art. So likewise, management is also called as art, and let's see some of its features. If we want to say a particular activity or a performance is called as art, that should consist of some of the characteristic features. So here also some of the features are listed to know whether and to have a clear idea whether management is an art. So out of that, the first one is existence of theoretical knowledge. So whatever may be the art, we need some theoretical knowledge or some practical material to understand and to perform that particular activity. So that's why it is mentioned here. In every art, systematic and organized study material should be available compulsorily to acquire a theoretical knowledge. So knowledge is important to perform an art. The second characteristic feature is personalized application. The point is, the use of basic knowledge differ from person to person, and thus art is a very personalized concept. That is a kind of uniqueness. One person is differing from another person to perform something or to execute something because their basic knowledge or some idea about a particular thing will be differing from one person to another person. So that's why they are telling art is a very personalized concept. That is the unique one. We have to modulate it or we have to mold it in a different way, and the way it is performed by one person to another person will also be getting differed, depends on their knowledge. That is the basic knowledge of each and every individual person, and that's why this is a personalized application. The third feature is based on practice and creativity. Art involves in consistent and creative practice of existing theoretical knowledge. We have something as a record, we have something as a practicing mode, but thing is, we have to practice again and again to perform that particular art in a very effective way, and also that should be in a creative way, because being in this competitive situation, every art, it can be any other particular thing or maybe any management oriented thing, we have to perform with more practice. Then only we can give the result in a very good manner. Like that, the creativity is also a very important one. So that is what mentioned here. After discussing all the three characteristic features, here is a conclusion whether management is an art or not. In management also, a huge volume of literatures and books are available on different aspects of management. That is, we have so many number of books and so many literatures and reviews that is speaking about management even today from the very long period, that is from our ancient period. You may get to know all these things in your future topics and maybe in future studies. And every manager has his own style of managing things and people. In the feature point, we have noted that One person is differing from another person in their basic knowledge. So just like the same, it is mentioned that every individual manager has their own style and creative idea to perform their activity. So activity here means managing the things or people. And the next one, he uses his creativity in applying management techniques and his skills improve with regular application. Every organization will have their own goal that we have discussed in the previous session. Just like that, for their successful achievement of the organizational goal and for the other task completion, every manager and every management and the organization will have their own creative ideas and techniques as well as the skills to improve and to perform their business in an effective way. So, here is the conclusion. Since all the features of art are present in the management, so it can be called as an art. So what they are saying, what are all the features listed in the points, the same things are matching to the management also. So definitely we can tell management is an art. Management is coming under the category of art. Here comes the second and the next important argument and discussion about management, whether management is a science. And let's see it in detail with some of the characteristic features that is matching with science. Like if you want to say what are all the things is coming under science that should match with these characteristics. Let's see it in detail. Before the characteristic features, we should be very clear about the term science. Let's see what is it. Science is a systematized body of knowledge that is based on general truth which can be tested anywhere and anytime. Science is a complete truth, a knowledge which consists of some of the truth and that can be experimented or tested at any time and wherever required. The first feature is systematized body of knowledge. Science has a systematized body of knowledge based on principles and experiments. We all know sciences like physics, chemistry, botany, zoology, or whatever the thing we are studying and we have crossed so far, and so many other advanced science and technologies we yet to know, and that some of the things we already know. Everything is consist of some of the principles and experiments, which is consist of a systematized body of knowledge. That particular science or particular aspect may consist of a knowledgeable points and aspects, and also it will have some principles and experiments. So experiments, we mean to say some of the practical oriented thing. And second, principles based in experiment and observation. Scientific principles are developed through experiments and observation. We may cross various experiments like prism or so many other science experiments that we have crossed. Everything may consist of some of the observations, and you will do some practical oriented thing. Take an example. If you are taking chemistry, there are a lot of formulas and lot of statements that we have to find some solution. So just like that, each and every science aspect may consist of the experiments and observations. Then only we can come to a conclusion or to find a result of a particular problem or a thing. The third characteristic is universal validity. Definitely, this science is called as a universal one because everything has been experimented and observed, and then only people are coming to a conclusion. So, it is applicable to the entire world wherever it is implementing. Let's see what the conclusion says. Management has a systematic body of knowledge and its principles are developed over a period of time based on repeated experiments and observations which are universally applicable, but they have to be modified according to the given situations. So what they are saying here is management is also having a body of knowledge. It consists of some set of principles and was developed over a period of time. From long period, management was there. And in what basis they have done? It is based on the repeated experiments and observations. There were so many number of experiments, researches and observations has been done in the field of management also. And there has a proof too. But the thing is, we have to implement it according to the situation. And the next point is, as the principles of management are not as pure as the principles of science. So it may be called as inexact science. Sciences consist of complete principles, and in case of management, it is little varying. It is getting different. So this management will not be called as the pure science. We can tell it is a, and they are saying it is a inexact science. The prominence of human factor in the management makes it as social science. So what is the conclusion here is, instead of saying management as a science or pure science, it is called as the social science. Here comes the last and the final argument and the discussion about management. Whether management as a profession. Let's see it. Let's be clear what is mean by profession. Profession means an occupation for which specialized knowledge and skills are required and entry is restricted. There should be some specific knowledge or skill required to say particular thing is called as a profession. Not all the people are qualified and eligible for a particular profession. We cannot tell all the people are qualified for something in particular or all the people are eligible to be in a particular profession. So some of the examples like doctors, lawyers, teachers, engineers and so on. To be in that particular profession, we need to be qualified and we need to have some experiences in that particular field. And let's see some of the characteristic features which is telling a particular thing or a particular eligibility called as the profession. The first characteristic feature is well-defined body of knowledge. All the professions are based on well-defined body of knowledge specified with particular qualification and experience. If you want to tell that you belongs to that particular profession or maybe you belongs to that particular field, definitely a particular set of knowledge is required to be in that profession. The second is restricted entry. The entry in every profession is restricted through examination or through some minimum educational qualification. We cannot tell after completing schooling or maybe some irrelevant education of a UG background or something that I am a doctor. Like that, I am an engineer and I am an IAS. Just like that, we need a particular minimum level of educational qualification or maybe some experience at least, as well as some of the examinations to be crossed. Once you have done with any of these things like examination or a good qualification, you can tell that you belongs to that particular profession. So that's why the entry is restricted here. The third is professional association. All professionals are affiliated to a professional association which regulates entry and frames the code of conduct relating to a profession. So whatever the profession you are taking, that may be a doctor or an engineer or maybe teacher or whatever it is, there is some association. That is, a group of people or a team of people will be engaging in a formal way to provide the regulation for or to lead the people who is coming under that particular association. That we will be seeing in so many examples in the future thing. The fourth is ethical code of conduct, ethics, legal or a moral rules every individual follow to maintain some disciplines in a particular field. You may belong to any profession, all professions are bounded by a code of conduct, some set of written and a specified regulations and rules to be followed, and that will be guided by the senior people or the people who is leading that particular association. So they will guide the behavior of all its members. They will be taking care of all the members. If anybody crossed out of it, they will be get punished, or if anybody is in that particular association, everyone should follow the code of conduct. And the final characteristics under this topic is service motive. The main aim of a profession is to serve its client. Just like the previous examples, you may belong to any profession, an IAS officer, a doctor, an engineer, or anybody like a teacher. There should be a service behind that particular profession. The motive of being in one particular profession should be serving to their clients or serving to the people who is belonging to that or who is waiting to get some benefits from that particular service or profession. Let's see what is the conclusion here, whether management as profession or not. Management does not fulfill all the features of the profession, and thus it is not a full-fledged profession like doctor, lawyer, etc. So here what is the argument comes as a conclusion is, as like the features which is specifying for one particular profession, management is not fulfilling everything. So we cannot tell management is completely a profession just like a doctor or a lawyer. But what they are telling is, very soon it will be recognized as full-fledged profession, because in recent days there are so many modifications is happening to prove that management is also having all this eligibility. So according to the belief of the people who has an argument about the thing, definitely management will also be called as a profession in future. That is what they are showing in front of us. Let's have a recap of all the three things which we discussed. Management is an art or science or a profession. By comparing the characteristic features of each and everything, there was a conclusive statement comes that management is completely an art and management is not a pure science. Instead, we can call it as a social science. And final thing is, management is not considered completely as a profession for now, and they argues definitely management will be called as a profession in future. So these are all the things we have discussed in the today's session, and we'll see you all soon with the final topic of chapter 1 with part 4. So like and share, subscribe to Shakti's Knowledge Hub, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for the future notification. Thank you all for watching. Shatter the Bridgemans and release your success journey. Have a good day. Bye.